Hi guys, Srikanth here. Today in this session we are going to talk about one of the important function, that is null if. Recently I was working with one of my code and I was facing one issue while executing that code, and I was getting runtime error, and that error was divide by zero. Okay, so how was my code actually? I'm just giving one snippet for that. The code was like select, let's say first value divide by second value, right? And here the thing was, the first was having the value and second was also having the value, but the value for the second value is something like zero, I'm just creating some initial setting so it will be clear for us. The value for the first was 1 and the value for the second was 0, right? So when I was executing this code, if you'll see here, I was getting divide by 0 error. So obviously we can see here that why was I getting this error divide by 0, because the value 0 is present in the divide, right? So whenever we will divide any value by 0, we'll get the error, and that error will be divide by 0 error encounter. So this is exception, of course. So to avoid this kind of error or exception, we will go by the case statement. Like we can write here something kind of thing, case when second value is equal to 0, then perform some operation, like then only perform, then just show me the first value, else go by the natural way how it will perform, assuming the value is not 0. So how it will perform, so it will just consider the first and second and the end, right? So when I execute this code again, will I get the error? No, I will not get the error. So this is the one way I can do. But if you see here that I have used case statement here, right? So instead of using this case statement, why don't I use something like that, where I don't want to use the case statement, because I don't want to use case statement, right? So in that case, we'll do a simple thing here. We'll apply one function, and that function is called as a null if. What exactly it will do? It will just compare the values, first value and the second value. Now what I am thinking, this null if require two parameter, right? So what will I do? I will pass two parameter. The first parameter will be the second value, which I am thinking it will be 0, and I am comparing this as a 0. Let's say what will happen with null if? If both the values are same, then it will return as a null. If both values are not same, then it will simply return the first value. So in this case, what will happen? It will return the null, because null if of 0 comma 0 will be 0, because both values are the same. Sorry. So here we will write is null. So when it will return null, just simply make that 1, right? So when I'm executing this entire code, these are the two ways to avoid the divide by 0 exception, and I'm getting the 1. So this is the best way to avoid the divide by 0 exception, and this is the simplest way to understand the null if. Hope you like this video. Please don't forget to share and subscribe our YouTube channel. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.